So hello students. So in previous session we have discussed the problems on the force between the two masses. So next we will discuss the some problems on gravitation field intensity and the gravitation potential. Okay, so we know that what is a gravitation field intensity. So gravitation field intensity due to a point mass at a distance r will be equal to g, that is g m by r square. And what is the gravitation field intensity? So gravitation field intensity is force per unit mass, and the direction will be what? Towards the mass. So the direction of gravitation field intensity will be towards the mass, and the potential due to this mass will be equal to minus g m by r. So one thing you should remember, this g is a vector quantity and this v is a scalar quantity, and the relation between the gravitational field intensity and g is, so g will be equal to minus dv by dr. So we can also write minus g dot dr is equal to dv. So you can integrate also. So on integrating both the side, we will have potential difference will be equal to minus times integral of g dot dr. So now we'll discuss some problems on this gravitation field. So this question is, let the gravitation field intensity E or G is given as minus k by r. If the reference point is at a distance d, di or d1, where the potential is v1, then what is the relation between the potential and gravitational field intensity? So here in this question, it is given as at point d1, at a distance from the center, potential is at d1, potential is given as v1. So what will be the relation? So we know that E is equal to minus dv by dr. So we can say minus integral of E dot dr is equal to potential difference. Okay. So here minus E is equal to this. So minus k by r dr. And here integral delta v, but here we have to substitute limit also. So limit is what? From d1 to, let's say, at a distance r, let's say is this is a point mass m, and at a distance d1 the potential is given as v1, and we want to know what is the potential at any position r. So from d1 to r, so at d1 the potential will be what? This is actually dv. After integration this will be delta v. So v1 to v. So this minus minus cancel. So integral of k is constant. Integral of 1 by r is what? Ln r. So here we can say ln r limit d1 to r, and here potential difference, you, this will be what? V. So upper limit minus lower limit, so V minus V1, and this will be what? Upper limit, so ln R minus ln D. So log A minus log B. So here we can say ln R minus ln D1 V minus, sorry, V minus V1. So log A minus log B is what? Log A by V, and so this will be what? Ln R by D1. So V minus V1 equal to ln R by D1. So we can say V is equal to V1 plus ln R by D1. So this is actually potential. So no relation between electric field intensity. So they are asking potential. So which option is correct? Here one thing we have missed, one thing, k. See, here k will also come. So K ln. This is K, so we missed that. So this will be the correct answer. Okay. So next question is sorry. A gravitation field at the center of a semicircle formed by a thin wire AB of mass M and length L. Okay, so this length is given as L as shown in figure. So they are asking what is the gravitation field intensity at the center. Okay, so here let us find out what is the radius. So total circumference is 2 pi r. Let us assume that the radius is r. So full circumference is 2 pi r, but this half circumference is what? Pi r. So pi r is given as L. So radius is known to us, that is L upon pi. Now we know what is the value of radius. So what is the gravitational field intensity at this point? And you can remember this direct result also in NEET. You can remember this direct result. So first we'll see how to calculate. So let's say we have this semicircular ring. And so what we'll do, we will cut this ring into small, very, very small pieces so that we will have small number of point masses. So this mass will apply a gravitation field here. Due to this mass, there will be some gravitation field due to this mass also. So at this point, the net gravitation field intensity will be the resultant of the gravitation field intensity due to all masses, all point masses. So for this, now how to calculate the value? See, one thing you should remember, in this case, the net gravitation field intensity will be in y direction only, because in x direction it will cancel. Means, see, suppose this is the element and focus this element. Due to this element, gravitation field intensity is here, and due to this element, gravitation field intensity is here. So this will have one component here, and this will also have one component here, and this will have one component up. This will also have one component up. So the vertical component of this and vertical component of this, they will add up. But this horizontal component in opposite direction. So this will cancel out this. This will cancel out this. So only the gravitation field intensity will be in y direction. So how to calculate? So to calculate is, we know what is the gravitation field intensity due to a point mass. So gravitation field intensity due to a point mass is gm by r square. Okay. So let's take a small element at an angle theta, and it is making a very small angle d theta. Suppose this element is present here at an angle theta, means theta is the angular position of this particle, and the angular width is d theta, very small, because this is a point mass. So we know that arc is equal to radius into theta. So if radius is r, so this is also radius r, this is also, so this arc length of this small element will be equal to r into, and angle substance is d theta. So this small element will have this much length. So what is the length of the wire? L. So in L meter, mass is what? M. So in whole L meter, M mass is uniformly distributed. So in every 1 meter, what should be the mass? M by L. 10 meter, 5 kilogram. So 1 meter, 0.5 kilogram, like this. So in 1 meter, this is the mass. And what is the length of this element? This is what? Rd theta. So in this length, what will be the mass? In this length, mass will be, in 1 meter, this mass. In 2 meter, 2m by L. In Rd theta meter, mass will be what? M R d theta by L. So this is the mass present in this length, which is equal to the mass of this small element. Let's say we can say dm. So dm is the mass of this small element. Okay. Now this small element will apply some gravitational field intensity in this direction, and let's say that is very small gravitational field intensity dg. So dg will be equal to g mass of that element, that is dm, by distance square. So this is the gravitational field intensity due to this mass here. Now if we will add the gravitational field intensity due to all the point masses, then we will find what is the net gravitational field intensity at this point. But the thing is, all the element are not having gravitational field in same direction, so directly we cannot take integrate. So here let's say this is dg, is this is dg, and this is theta. So here we can say the component of the gravitational field intensity along x direction dgx is dg cos theta, and the component of this element along y direction is dg y is dg sin theta. And we know that the dx will cancel out, because the component of this element in this direction and the component of this element is in this direction, they will cancel out. So only survive will be in vertical direction. So we can say net electric field intensity at center will be the summation of all the electric field in y direction only, is integration of dgy. And dgy is what? Dg sin theta. Dg sin theta. Now we'll substitute the value of dg. G is constant, so it is what, dm. We'll substitute the value of dm also. So m r d theta upon gm by r square, this r square by l, and this sine theta. And here we will substitute the value also, pi r equal to l, or l equal to pi r. Suppose here we are substituting l equal to pi r, so we will get this l is equal to pi r. So r will cancel, so it will be g m integral of sine theta d theta, and here r square into pi. And r is the radius of this shell, ring, semicircular ring, which is also constant, so we can take this out also. So here we can write this gravitation field intensity e or g. You can write e or g, so it will be what, g m by pi r square integral of sine theta d theta. Now the first element is located here, for this angle will be 0. Now for this last element is here, for this angle is 180. So limit will be what? So first element will have theta equal to 0 degree, and the last element will have theta equal to 180 degree or pi degree. So integral of sine theta is what? Minus cos theta, let's say. So it will be what? G m by pi r square. So cos theta 0 to pi. So here it will be what? Minus g m pi r square. Cos pi is what? Upper limit minus lower. Cos pi minus cos 0. So cos pi is minus 1. Minus cos 0 is 1. So this is what? Minus 1 minus 2. So minus minus cancel out. So you will get, here I am writing, this will be what? 2 g m by pi r square. So this is the net gravitational field intensity at the center of a semicircular ring. And directly you can remember this result also. In NEET, suppose they are asking, then directly you can choose this option. So you should remember this also. And one thing you should remember, the gravitational field intensity is towards in upward direction. There is no horizontal component of gravitation field intensity along x direction. There is gravitation field intensity along y direction only. So which option is correct? 2gm upon pi r square. 2gm. Here actually r is not mentioned, so we have to convert this r into l also. So if you will substitute here, so this is 2gm pi r. R will be what? L by pi. So this will be what? L square by pi square. So I am taking pi square is up. So this cancel, this cancel. So 2 pi gm by l square. 2 pi gm by l square along upward direction. So this will be correct. Okay. So this relation you should remember. So now we are moving to the next problem. Okay, so next problem is a very large number of same mass m are kept at a horizontal distance 1 meter, 2 meter, 4 meter, 8 meter and so on from 0, 0 means origin. The total gravitation potential at this point is, okay, so let's say this is origin 0, 0. So at 1 meter, m mass is here. This is what? 1. And another means this total is 2, means from this. So this is 1, means 1, 2. Again, m mass is here. And 1. Next is what? 4. So next is what? 2. Again, m. So see, 1 meter, 2 meter, 4 meter. So the distance is at from center. So like this, infinite masses are there. So we know that what is the gravitation potential. So V is equal to minus G M by R. Minus G M by R. So this is potential and gravitational field intensity is minus G M by R square. Okay. And potential is scalar, so no need for integration or anything, directly we can add. So the potential due to this at here will be V1, means due to this, minus G M by 1 plus the potential due to this minus G M by distance from here to this point 2 plus the potential due to this minus G M by 4 plus minus G M by 8, so on. So you can take minus G common, minus G M. So you will get 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 up to infinity. And see, this is what? A GP. And first term is 1 and ratio is what? 1 by 2. So multiply 1 by 2 into this, then you will get this. Again multiply 1 by 2 in this, you will get this. Again multiply 1 by 2 here. So in this case, first term A is 1 and common ratio is what? 1 by 2. And sum of infinite GP, you should remember, A upon 1 minus R. So here A is 1 and R is this. So we can substitute what is the value of this. So I am writing here minus G M into A is what? 1 upon 1 minus R. R is 1 by 2. So 1 upon 1 minus 1. So this will be 1 by 2. So 1 upon 1 by 2. So 2 will come up. So this will be minus 2 G m. So this is the potential at origin. So option D is correct. Okay. So A is 1, C 1 upon 1 minus 1 by 2. So 1 minus half is half. So 1 upon 1 by 2. So 2 will come up. So this will be 2 only. So next is, so this understood? And after this live session, you can watch this video recording also. You can watch this recording also, where you can pause this video also. But in this live session, you cannot pause. Okay. So one thing here we should discuss, that is, suppose we have a hollow shell. Hollow shell means mass is present here and it is having mass m and radius capital R. And suppose you want to know what is the gravitation field intensity at point P. Let's say the distance from the center is R. So if R is greater than R, means this P point is outside, then the gravitation field intensity is G m by R square. But if the R is less than R, means inside, then the gravitation field intensity will be 0, because inside everywhere no mass is present. So on the same logic, the next question is, so in this question they are saying two concentric shell of uniform density of mass m1 and m2 are located like this. Now force experienced by a mass m when placed at position A, B and C, and the distance of A from center, B from center, C from center is given as P, Q, R. So we have to find what is the force experienced by the mass m when that mass is placed at point A, B or C. Okay. So we know that the gravitation field intensity is also equal to force 1 into mass. Then force is equal to mass into gravitation field intensity. Okay. So first of all, we'll find what is the gravitation field intensity at point C. So C is a point which is inside of this shell and also this shell. So there will be no gravitation field intensity due to this shell at point C, because C point is inside of the shell, and there will be no gravitation field intensity due to this shell also, because this C point is also inside of this M2 shell. So total will be 0. So we can say if G is 0, force will be 0. So mass is M, but gravitation field intensity is 0. So total force is 0. So if at point C, if you are putting a mass m, then force on that mass will be 0. Now B point. See, B point is outside of this shell, but inside of this bigger shell. So we can say at point B, the gravitation field intensity, the gravitation field intensity due to this bigger shell will be 0. But there, this B point is outside of this smaller shell. So the gravitation field intensity due to this will be G M1 by R. And R is the distance from center, that is OB. And OB is given as Q. So we will write this. So force will be what? MG. So G M1 M by Q. So this will be the force on M mass when it is placed at point B. Now this A point is outside of what? Outside of this smaller shell and bigger shell. So there will be gravitation field intensity due to both. And the gravitation direction of gravitation field intensity is towards the mass. So because of this shell is here, and because of bigger shell is also in the same direction. So net gravitation field intensity at point A, first due to this G M1. Now what is the distance from center to point A, OA? all the distance is taken from the center. So OA is given as P. So this is the gravitational field intensity due to this M1 mass. Now the gravitational field intensity due to this bigger shell. Again we will take the distance from center. So the gravitational field intensity due to this mass will be G M2, and distance from the center again is OA. See OA. The distance of a point A from center is OA. Again P. So here take G common and P common. P is correct? Yes, P is correct. M1 plus M2. Capital. So force will be what? Mg. So multiply this M also in case of force. So what they are asking? The force experienced by the particle mass A, B, C. So A is what? This. B is what? This M1M. This. C0. So this is correct. So GA into small m. So you will get this G capital M1 plus M2 by P square. So we did mistake actually. In G it is what? R square. Sorry. So G M1 M2 by R square. So this will be Q square. Okay. So this is the correct answer. Okay, so now next question is, so actually next question is on gravitation potential and self energy. 1 minute. Actually, two questions are remaining on the previous concept. So the question is, figure shows a hemispherical shell having uniform density, uniform mass density. The direction of gravitational field intensity at point P will be. So, one thing you should remember, suppose this is a hollow shell, half. Suppose if this is complete, so inside everywhere the gravitational field intensity is what? Zero. So we can say this half part has gravitation field intensity everywhere in this side, and this half part is having gravitation field intensity in this side. So if you have full, so total will be zero, but suppose if you have half this like this, in this case the gravitation field intensity will be downward. So it will be in downward direction. And here they are asking the potential relation. So we know that there is at this point the gravitation field intensity means, 1 minute, a mass m is uniformly distributed here. And one thing you should remember that g is equal to minus dv by dr. And here, if this is hemispherical, then G is constant. Here. And if this is closed, then G will be what? Zero. So one thing you should remember, if G is zero, then dV by dr is not zero. So if gravitation field intensity is zero, then we can say the potential will be, the differentiation of anything is zero. It means that is thing is constant. It means V is what? Constant. So in this case, the potential will be everywhere be same, but actually in practical case the potential is not same. But the thing is, for theoretical point of view the potential will be same. So one thing you should remember, if the size is small then we can consider, But if size is large, so we cannot consider. So up to neat level we can say here the potential will be same, but practically it is not same. So next is gravitation potential energy and self energy. So we know that suppose we have two masses m1 and m2 and they are separated by distance r, so the gravitation potential energy between them will be minus g m1 m2 by r. So this is the gravitation, or also called as interaction potential energy. Okay, so the question is, a body starts from rest at a point a distance r naught from the center of the earth of mass m and radius r. The velocity acquired by the body when it reaches the surface of the earth will be okay, so suppose we have this earth and a body of mass, let's say small m. This earth is having mass m and radius r, and this mass m is at a distance of capital R naught. So assume that the earth is not moving, earth is fixed. In that case, what is the gravitation potential energy in this case? So initial potential energy is minus g capital M small m by R naught. And when this body will reach to the surface, then the distance between the center of the earth and the body will be equal to radius of earth. So in that case, what is the final potential energy? Minus g capital M small m by R. So this is the final potential energy. This is, so whatever the change in potential energy will be gained by the kinetic energy. So initial is more, final is less, that is why it is gaining kinetic energy. So here we can say, so change in kinetic energy will be about change in kinetic energy will be equal to change in potential energy. So here we can say minus g capital M small m by R naught minus g m by R. This is what change in potential energy. This will be equal to half mv square, because this is loss in potential energy is gained as the kinetic energy. So we can solve. So this will be minus minus plus. You can take common. I am writing here g capital M small m, and you will get 1 by r minus 1 by r naught. So this will be equal to half m v square. You can cancel m. So this 2 will go here. So v will be what? Under root of 2 capital G capital M r naught minus r upon r r naught. Or you can write like this. You can remain 1 by r. So this 2g, so this will be correct. Okay, so next question is, so here was simple logic is the change in potential energy is equal to change in kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy is zero, so final kinetic energy will be equal to change in potential energy. Okay, so obviously initial potential energy is more because when this mass is approaching here, so the potential energy is decreasing, that is why the kinetic energy is increasing. So that is why initial minus final will be equal to this. Now next case, 1 minute. So in this question, three equal masses, each of mass m, are placed at a corner of a equilateral triangle of side A. Now they are asking four question or option. 1 minute. No, four questions are there. So if If fourth particle of equal mass is placed at center of a triangle, the net force on it will be equal to. This is a simple question actually. See, suppose you have equilateral triangle like this. So suppose equal masses here, see, equal masses. So if equal masses are placed, then the gravitational field intensity at center will be zero because it will be cancelled out. Here, here, here. So all are equal, so they will cancel out. But if mass is different, then there will be some gravitational field intensity. So if g is zero, then if you are putting any mass, then force will be mg, so F is also zero. So this, for this first case, answer is zero. They are asking the net force acting on it will be equal to zero. So next is, in above problem, if fourth mass is at the midpoint of the side, the net force on it will be equal to. So this is good question. So now they are saying, suppose we are not putting at the center, we are putting here. So what will be the net force? And see, I am not taking this, means this is not very hard question. I am taking this type of question so that whole concept will be clear. Because in every question you are seeing more than two concepts are involved. So let's say this is M and this is M. And they are saying now if M mass is placed here, so what is the net force? See, because of this F1 will be there. Because of this F2 or F1 will be there. Both are same because distance is same midway. So they will cancel out. But there will be some force due to this only. So, and this distance we know how to calculate. See, this distance. This is A, this is A, this is A. So this will be what? 60 degree. So this total distance is, this is A. So this is A cos 60, this is A sin 60. Same like this. So this distance is A sin 60. This is A cos 60, A sin 60. So here only one remaining force will be this F2. So F2 will be what? G M1 M2 by distance. Distance is what? A sin 60. Sin 60 means root 3a by 2. So square, so this will be what? 3a square by 2 square means 4. So 4 will come up. So it will be what? 4g m square by 3a square. So this will be the force on the fourth mass. So option B is correct. So here net for this force, they will cancel out. Because this is applying one force here, this is applying one force here, they will cancel out. So only remaining force will be this force. So that will be this. And the distance is equal to C. This is A, this is 60. So this is A cos 60 is this, A sin 60 is this. So for this answer is correct. In above given three particle system, of equilateral triangle, side A is to be changed to 2A. Okay, then work done. Okay. Means they are saying, suppose we have initially this system of mass M, 3M mass, and they are located at the vertices of a equilateral triangle like this M, 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 and distance is A, A, A. Now they are saying, now change this side to 2A. Now how much amount of work we have to do in this case? Means suppose we are increasing the this length and we are taking this as 2A, 2A, 2A. Then in that case, how much amount of work we have to do from this to this? So the thing is, first calculate what is the potential energy of this. And what is the potential energy of this? Work done will be equal to final potential energy minus initial potential energy. Means, see, suppose initially energy is 200 and finally is 500. It means you have to supply 300 joule of work. Understood? That is why final minus initial. So potential energy U is what? Minus G M1 M2 by R. Okay. So minus G M1 M2 by R. So we have this pair, this pair, this pair, because this is the interaction potential energy. So the potential energy U1 is minus G M1 M2 means M square by A minus G M square by A minus G. So directly we can write three times. Because minus G M square by A, minus G M square by A, minus G M square by A. This is the initial potential energy. Final potential energy will be minus G M square by 2A minus G M square by 2A minus G into 3. So work done will be equal to, this is what? Minus 3 G M square by 2A minus minus plus minus 3 G M square by A. So here this will be what? Plus, take 3 G M square by A as common. So you will get here minus 1 by 2 and here 1. So 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. So this will be what? 3 G M square by 2A. So this is the amount of work that we have to do. Here the question is, means initially three M masses are located at the vertices of a equilateral triangle. Now the side is changed to from A to 2A, then what amount of work we have to do here? So simply calculate what is the initial potential energy of the system. And in the system we have three interaction pair, 1, 2, 3. And also calculate what is the final potential energy of the system. So work done will be equal to final potential energy minus initial potential energy. So this is 3gm square by 2a. 3gm square by 2a. 3gm square by 2a. So it means this B option is correct. Okay. So in the above given three particle system, if two particle are kept fixed and third particle is released, then the speed of the particle when it reaches, okay. So they are saying in this system we have M, M and M. These two masses are kept fixed, means they cannot move. But third mass can move. So they are saying when this, due to the gravitational attraction, see, force is here, due to this, force is here. So both forces are same and the angle is same. So this horizontal component will cancel out, only vertical component will survive. So there will be force in vertical downward direction. So on releasing, this mass will move in downward direction only. Okay, so they are saying when this mass will reach here, what will be the velocity? Okay, so here we can use two concepts, that is work done is potential difference into mass. Let's say this is point P and this is Q. So here mass is going from Q to P. So potential, how to find potential difference will be where you are going, point P. So potential of point P minus potential of Q. And potential we know how to calculate, minus Gm by R. So suppose you want to know what is the potential at this point Q due to this, because this is moving. So first of all, what is the potential at this point? So we can say due to this, potential means potential at point Q is first due to this minus Gm by A. Due to this mass, and due to this mass again minus Gm by A. So total will be minus 2 Gm by A. So this is the total potential at point Q. Now at point P, potential due to this and this, and see, this total is A, so this distance is A by 2. So the potential due to this mass is minus gm by e by 2, and potential due to this minus gm by e by 2. So this will be what, minus 4 gm by e. So here we can say potential difference will be here minus, you can subtract Vq minus V, because we have to take potential difference positive. So this difference will be what, magnetic magnitude only, so 4 minus 2, 2. So potential difference work done will be what, 2 gm by A, this one is this, into m, because this mass is going from here. So potential difference into mass, this is work done. So this amount of work is done on this mass, and this work done will be converted into the kinetic energy. So whatever this gravitation field is doing work on this, this work will be gained by the kinetic energy. So here we can say half mv square, so mf cancel. So v will be equal to 4gm. This is what? Gm. So this cancel by a under root. So this is our first method to calculate the velocity. And another a method is also potential energy method. So here we can say method is find the potential difference. So potential difference into mass will be work done, and that work will be equal to gain in kinetic energy. And second method is, initially the system is like this, m is here, m is here, m is here. And finally the system is like this, m, m, m. So what will be the potential energy? Minus g m square by a into 3. And here what is the final energy? First interaction between this, minus g m square by a by 2, and interaction between this, minus g m square by a by 2. But also there is interaction between this, so three pairs will be there, minus g m square by a. So 2 2 1, so this will be what, minus what, 5 g m square by a. So u final minus u initial will be equal to work done, final minus initial. So 5 minus 3 will be 2, 2 g m square by a. So this is the work done, and this work done will be equal to half mv square. Same answer will come. So you will get v is equal to under root of 4 g m by a. Next question is, next topic is Kepler's law for satellite, orbital velocity and escape velocity. So orbital velocity means, suppose we have a planet m and a satellite, let's say mass of planet is mp, and a satellite whose mass is ms, and it is revolving around this planet in a radius r, in this orbit whose radius is r. So let's say it is moving with velocity v, so it requires some centripetal force, that is ms v square by r, and this required centripetal force is provided by the gravitation force. So g mp ms by r square. So this orbital velocity will be under root g
mp by r. So remember, this orbital velocity does not depend on the mass of satellite. Or in the case, if planet is revolving around the sun, in that case the orbital velocity of planet does not depend on the mass of planet, it depends on about which it is orbiting. So, and the escape velocity is what, that is 2 times g m by r. So that we'll discuss. So first they are asking, a periodic time of a satellite revolving around Earth is proportional to density. So here, how to calculate the time period? Suppose a satellite, let's say this is the mass of planet and this is satellite, and this satellite is revolving. So time period is, time is what, distance by speed. So time period means time to complete one rotation. So time period will be equal to distance of one circle, that is 2 pi r, by velocity. Okay, now t will be equal to 2 pi r, and velocity we have discussed under root g m, means here mass, here planet is Earth, so we will write me by r. So now squaring both sides, you will get t square equal to 4 pi r cube by g m e. So we will not take this. So t square is proportional to this, and mass is equal to what? Volume to density. And for volume of Earth, we can say 4 upon 3 pi r cube, into density or rho. So here we can write t square is equal to the here r cube 4 upon 3 pi r cube rho. So this cancel, this cancel. So t square is proportional to, inversely proportional to rho. So t is proportional to 1 upon under root rho. So time period is inversely proportional to root of this density of the Earth. So this is the correct answer. Okay, next question is, an artificial satellite of Earth releases a package. If air resistance is neglected, the point where the package will hit with respect to the position and time of release. So suppose this is our Earth, and any satellite is rotating. So suppose any satellite is releasing any package. So suppose if it is moving with the speed of 500 km/h, let's say. So this is also moving with the same speed, 500 km/h. So it means if you are releasing, not throwing, so this satellite and this package will move with same velocity, and the Earth will also provide the required centripetal for this. So it means they will move parallelly in a circular path. So this satellite and this mass both will move parallelly in the circular path. So here what they are asking, the resistance neglected, the package will hit. So package will not hit. So package, it will not never reach to the Earth, because it will start orbiting, because the orbital velocity of the package is also, means orbital velocity means the velocity of satellite which is evolving in that orbit, and it is also having the same orbital velocity, so it will orbit also. So next is, an orbiting satellite will escape if, so we have to choose which option is correct. Okay, so let's say we have this planet or sun, and let's say any satellite is revolving at a radius r. Let's say this is ms. So what they are asking, its speed should increase by this, the its speed should be this, then it will escape. So they are asking for escaping condition. Okay, now here this satellite is revolving around this planet. So what is the total energy of satellite? So total energy of satellite will be the kinetic energy of satellite plus gravitation potential energy. So total energy of the satellite E will be equal to minus G MP MS by R plus kinetic energy of satellite of MS V orbital square. And we know that V orbital will be under root 2G MP by R. So you will substitute. So then you will get minus G MP MS by R plus half MS and 2G MP by R. So this will be this 2 cancel. So this is 1 minute. So this is what? No, this is not 1. V orbital is under root gm by r, gmp by r. So here it is not there. So this is what? Minus 1, and this is what? Plus 1 by 2. So final will be what? Minus g mp ms by r. So this is the total energy of the satellite. This is the total energy of the satellite. Now, when this satellite will reach to the infinity, only then it will escape. So what is the total energy at total energy when the satellite will escape? The satellite will reach to the infinity. In that case, R will be what? Infinity. So something upon, so in that case, total energy at infinite distance will be 1 upon infinity, that will be 0. So initial energy when it is orbiting is this. When this satellite will reach to the infinity, it will have 0 energy. Okay, so how much extra energy it is needed? So extra energy needed will be equal to E final minus E initial. So E final is 0 minus G MP MS by R. So this much amount of extra energy is needed, G MP MS by R. So this extra energy is needed, but the satellite is having only kinetic energy. So because this is the gravitational potential energy, so the satellite is having how much energy? Half m v square, and v is equal to under root gm by r. So we can say half satellite ms g mp by r. So this is what? The energy, kinetic energy, and this is the required. So now we will see what they are asking. Its speed should increase by this percent. And the speed should be like this. Now, see, suppose this mass wants to reach to the infinity. In that case, the extra energy means initially the system is having this energy, and when the satellite will reach to the infinity, it will have this energy. So extra energy is needed this. So this is the extra amount of energy needed. So here we can also calculate what should be the velocity so that it will reach to the infinity. So in this case, we can say
Suppose v velocity is given. Suppose v velocity is given, which is greater than the orbital velocity, then it will try to escape. So suppose by giving velocity v, it is reaching to the escape infinity. In that case, no external force is there, so no work will be done. So here we can apply energy conservation. So suppose we have given some velocity v. Now what will be the total energy in this case? The total energy at this case, suppose v velocity is given, in that case kinetic is half m v1 minus half m, this is at s m p r. So this is the total energy. And suppose if it is reaching to the infinity, suppose if it is reaching to the infinity, then gravitation potential energy will be zero, because gravitation is minus g m1 m2 by r, r will be infinity. So gravitation will be zero and it is reaching to the infinity, so velocity is become also zero. So initially it is having a total energy this, and when it reaches to the infinity, the energy will be zero. So why the conservation of energy? Because nobody, no extra force is there. So by the conservation we can say this equal to this. So means this equal to this. So half ms v1 square equal to g ms mp by r. So this cancel, this cancel. So v1 will be equal to what? Under root g mp by r. And this is what? 2. So 2 will come. See, this is not the orbital velocity. Here actually this is r, not capital R. In case of escape velocity from surface, that is 2 g mp by capital R. So suppose the satellite wants to escape, then it should have this velocity. But in case of orbital, it is having what? Orbital velocity. Means suppose if we are giving this velocity, then it will escape, but it is having what? This orbital velocity, that is gmp by r. So to escape, this velocity should be given to the satellite, then it will escape. But actually if it is not escaping, if it is orbiting, then it will have this orbital velocity. So see, v is what? Root 2 times of c v by v naught. So you'll get root 2. So here you can say velocity should be root 2 times of v naught. Velocity should be what? Root 2 times of v naught. So how much speed should be increased? They are asking, the speed should be increased by this. Initially, it is orbiting with velocity v naught, and if we are increasing and we are putting velocity root 2 v naught, then it will escape. So percentage change will be what? Final velocity minus initial velocity upon initial. So root 2 v naught minus v naught upon v naught into 100. So this will be root 2 minus 1 into 100. So this will be the percentage change in the velocity. So thank you. We have discussed this topic, and in one more class we will discuss some mixed problem of gravitation chapter. So thank you. We'll meet in the next class.